I'm enjoying commending the curriculum writers for what they've said. This is very, very good stuff. As much as anything, it's because of the amount of detail, the extra content. It's added a richness to what wasn't there before in terms of explaining to teachers what they're teaching and just opportunities for teaching. I love it, I love it, I love it. G'day teachers, I'm Peter Price. In this video, I'm going to review the proposed mathematics curriculum for 2022 for Year 5 students. And there isn't really a lot to say. I mean, there's a bit of text here on the slide, but really I'm happy with almost everything that's in here. The biggest change is there's much greater detail devoted to describing content descriptors. And I have to say, I think that's a good thing. The old curriculum had some very, very brief statements of what teachers were going to be doing. The new curriculum, by and large, has expanded. I would estimate there's an extra 40% in terms of the number of words, the number of letters that are in the content descriptors, and I think that is entirely a good thing. There's not many places where I think, I wish you hadn't said that. Wish you'd left that bit out because you don't need it. Okay, so that's good. The biggest gap, what's been left out? There's little individual topics, the sort of cherry-pick topics, as I'm calling it here. Geometric transformation of dilation has been removed. Choosing metric units has been removed. And using other two-dimensional representations of three-dimensional objects has been removed. So not much, little mini-topics, as it were. And in the summary, I see this as largely unchanged. There's a greater focus on modelling and problem solving and a much expanded set of content descriptors in statistics as there is across the board, across the different year levels. So let's look first at the first number content descriptor. We are looking at place value. Use place value understanding to interpret, write, name and rename numbers with more than two decimal places, including numbers greater than one. Compare, order, and locate, and represent these on a number line. I just like the list of verbs. There's so many different activities that you can ask students to do. You could teach for a long time just on that particular content descriptor. It's about having a deeper understanding of place value beyond hundredths. It doesn't say when to stop. That's good. So we can go to thousandths, ten thousandths, hundred thousandths, millionths. Let the students see that these numbers carry on indefinitely. Yeah, I love it. The second content descriptor refers to factors and multiples and divisibility rules. This is really good content. It's really useful. We decompose natural numbers, that means the positive whole numbers, into products of factors, recognize multiples using divisibility rules. This is very, very good. I like it. The third one, use estimation strategies appropriate to the context, including financial contexts, when making decisions about approaches to solving problems and to check the reasonableness of solutions. This is really good. This is a very nuanced sort of content descriptor. It focuses on estimation strategies appropriate to the context, as it says, when making decisions about approaches to solving problems. In other words, when you are solving a problem, quite often you make a decision about how accurate your answer needs to be and when you can estimate the answer quite safely and it won't affect the outcome of what you're planning to do and check the reasonableness of solutions. There's lots and lots of very valuable content. The fourth number content descriptor. Apply knowledge of factors and multiples to compare and order fractions with the same and related denominators, including numbers greater than one, represent them on number lines and explaining any equivalences and the order. Again, there's lots here. There's lots of really good content. It's interesting they've used a similar language here, which is the words including numbers greater than one, as they did in the first content descriptor, referring to decimals. So they've now applied the same language to fractions and they've linked this together with factors and multiples. Again, there's lots and lots of content. There's lots of valuable explanation of what is expected of students and therefore teachers. Very good. Number five is a new content descriptor in that there was no equivalent, no antecedent in the existing curriculum. So we have used percentages to describe, represent and compare relative size and recognize that 100% represents the complete whole, connect familiar percentages to their decimal and fraction equivalents. Wow, there's a lot there. There's lots of activities that could be done. This is a valuable addition to the curriculum. Number six, solve problems involving addition and subtraction of fractions with the same denominator, investigating different strategies. That's all in black, meaning it was the same wording in the old existing curriculum, as you can see on the left, including using different representations, and that's always a good thing. I like representations for modeling what maths students are learning. Number seven, choose efficient strategies to represent and solve problems involving multiplication of large numbers by one-digit or two-digit numbers using, that's all the same text. Then we have some additional information, basic facts, place value, properties of operations, and digital tools where appropriate, explaining the reasonableness of the answer. Boy, I really do commend the curriculum writers for the way they've expanded on these content descriptors. They're just wonderful. They've got a lot more language, a lot more verbs, a lot more opportunities for teachers to build valuable teaching activities. Well done, curriculum writers. I like it a lot. And they just expand on the meaning using basic facts, place value, properties of operations, and so on and so on and so on. Well done. I have made a comment in other videos about digital tools where appropriate. I think it's probably a good idea if the curriculum states that teachers should use digital tools where there's a chance they might not have thought of it, or where either that or there is a specific tool or set of tools that are essential as part of understanding a particular content descriptor. So in this case, I think you could have left it out. This is one of the few places where I say you might have left some words out, only because I think teachers need to be given the professional freedom to choose when to use technology and when not to use technology. Apart from, as I said, times when teachers might not think of a technology or there's a particular form of technology that is especially useful. Anyway, we'll move on to number eight. There's a lot of number content descriptors in Year 5, as you can see. There's nine in total. We have a long content descriptor. It's almost all in blue. It started off solve division problems, and it's ended up with the blue text added to say choose efficient strategies to represent and solve division problems using basic facts, place value, the inverse relationship between multiplication and division, and digital tools where appropriate. Interpret any remainder according to the context, yes, and express results as a mixed fraction or decimal. This is really good. This has really helped to beef up what's being asked of teachers and students in terms of division. There's lots of extra information. It includes digital tools that I think is appropriate in this case. Interpreting remainder was a big gap in the old curriculum. I'm glad to see that that's been filled. Let's move on. Number nine. We have another long content descriptor. Model situations, including financial contexts, formulating expressions using all the operations, choose efficient strategies using the properties of operations and digital tools where appropriate, justify choices and explain results in terms of the situation. So you're modeling, you're solving problems using all the operations, you're using appropriate strategies, you're taking into account properties of operations, and then you're explaining what you did and justifying your choices made. This is very, very powerful. It implies that students will be asked to choose what they're going to do to solve a problem. And that is a very, very powerful learning and teaching technique. Let's move on to algebra. Year 5 algebra, number 1. Continue and create extended number sequences with fractions, decimals, and natural numbers resulting from addition and subtraction. That's all the same. Using technology to assist where appropriate. Recognize and explain emerging patterns. Very good. There's really not much to say. The second one, find unknown values in equivalent number sentences involving multiplication and division. And some blue text. Applying an understanding of the associative, distributive, commutative, and inverse properties using factors and multiples. Identify and use equivalent number sentences involving multiplication and division to form numerical equations. This is really good. I keep saying that. I'm enjoying commending the curriculum writers for what they've said. This is very, very good stuff. As much as anything, it's because of the amount of detail, the extra content. It's added a richness to what wasn't there before in terms of explaining to teachers what they're teaching and just opportunities for teaching. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's got applying an understanding of the properties of operations, the associative, distributive, commutative, and inverse. Just one thing, I would like those to be explained somewhere. The elaborations would be fine somewhere. Let teachers know exactly what they are. And I only say that because I was shaky on what those meant for a long time, and I kept getting them mixed up, and I think that would be useful. Yeah. Well done, curriculum writers. And the third algebra content descriptor, which is completely new. The left-hand side is blank because there wasn't an equivalent in the existing current curriculum. So we have used algorithms and digital tools to explore factors and multiples and apply computational thinking to recognize, interpret, and explain emerging patterns. I love it. The word patterns is a little bit of code I've noticed in terms of number facts. Number facts have been downplayed, which is a big gap in the proposed curriculum, which I've talked about at length in the Year 3 and Year 4 videos. And they've put word patterns in there, where children are going to be exploring patterns and discovering patterns instead of learning number facts. In Year 5, I don't mind it including patterns if we can assume that number facts have been put back in the Year 3 and Year 4 curriculum. Anyway, exploring factors and multiples using technology and using algorithms is very, very powerful. It's wonderful. Again, I like it. Let's move straight on to measurement. Year 5 measurement number 1. Here we have recognized the relationship between the prefixes for metric units and choose to use smaller units or a combination of units to obtain a more accurate measure when measuring the length, mass, and capacity of objects. I will mention in the old one, it included measurement of area and volume, and that's been removed. Now, volume's gone completely, I think, until at least Year 7. Area was in Year 4 from memory, but it's not in Year 5. I don't quite know why that is. I'm not overly concerned because there's a lot to like in this new curriculum. Prefixes for metric units were left out of the previous curriculum, and they should have been there, I think. And using combinations of units and smaller units, that's very, very useful. So well done. The second measurement content descriptor says model situations and solve practical problems involving the perimeter of common shapes and the area of rectangles using appropriate metric units. Almost the same as the one previously, slightly more language, slightly more clarity in the description. The next one, number 3, we have compared 12-hour and 24-hour time systems. That's the same as the old one. Solve practical problems involving the conversion between them. Almost unchanged. Well done. Measurement number 4. We have estimate, construct, measure, and compare angles in degrees using appropriate tools, including a protractor, using conventional language to describe angles. Again, almost the same. It's been clarified and extended a little bit, and it's a good change. Well done. Let's move straight on to space. Year 5, space number 1. We have connect and construct objects from their nets. That's almost the same as the previous one. And create nets for objects using spatial and geometrical reasoning. That's all good. The second one, we have construct a grid coordinate system that uses coordinates to locate positions within a space. Use coordinates and directional language to describe position and movement. It's interesting that it's got the word construct. I think this is within the capabilities of Year 5 students. They will construct the grid themselves, or the grid coordinate system themselves, to locate positions within space. It's well done. It's well written. I'm speaking very positively in this video. I'm finding it a new experience, given my criticisms of some of the other things that we've said. Anyway, Year 5, space number 3, we have describe and perform translations, reflections, and rotations of shapes using dynamic geometric software where appropriate. Recognize and describe what changes and what remains the same under the transformation, and identify any rotational symmetries. Well done. Well written, lots of language that is useful. I like this phrase here, recognize and describe what changes and what remains the same. That's an important, if you like, mathematical analysis of a transformation. The transformations are mainly visual and geometric. To include recognizing and describing what's changed and what hasn't changed adds another aspect to this study, which I think is very powerful and very useful. And the fourth content descriptor for space doesn't have an equivalent. It's all new. We have used computational thinking to create algorithms involving decisions to sort and classify shapes and objects, experiment with different shapes and objects, sorting into categories, and recognizing any emerging patterns. This is somewhat similar to a content descriptor which I was heavily critical of in Year 4, involving finding patterns in the multiplication facts. So it's interesting, this similar language here. I suspect it was written by the same person. But this is referring to sorting shapes and objects and creating algorithms to do that. And basically, I like it. I like the extra emphasis on geometry and the analysis of shapes. It's very powerful. It has a lot more maths in it. I like it. And the next content descriptor has been removed compared to the old curriculum or the existing curriculum, and that was applying the enlargement or dilation transformation. That's gone completely. So I expect it appears somewhere else, but we're looking at Year 5 now. Let's look at probability. There are a few content descriptors here. Year 5 probability number 1 says, list the possible outcome of chance experiments involving equally likely outcomes. That's almost identical to the other one. And compare to those which are not equally likely. Nice expansion there. The second one is all new. Use experiments to observe and record the outcomes of repeated trials of chance events, including those with and without equally likely outcomes. Use frequency to compare outcomes and estimate their likelihoods. I like it. There's a lot we can do with probability. I always thought the previous curriculum had left probability a bit light on, so I'm pleased to see the extra language being added. The next content descriptor, which used to be in Year 5, was recognized that probabilities range from 0 to 1, and that's been moved completely to Year 6. We're almost at the end. We're down to the last three content descriptors. They're all in statistics, and they're all long in terms of the language that's been used. There's a lot more detail than there used to be, and they're almost all in blue, so it's all new language. We have acquire, validate, and represent ordinal and discrete numerical data in different ways using software, including spreadsheets and graphs. Discuss and report on data distributions in terms of highest frequency and shape, as a mode and shape in the context of the data. It's well written. I suspect that whoever wrote these content descriptors for statistics may have also written the content descriptors for Year 5 generally. They're very well written. They're clear. They're easy to understand. They have appropriate mathematical terminology. They're basically well done. Whoever you are, congratulations. You did a great job. The second statistics content descriptor for Year 5, construct, interpret, and compare data represented as line graphs using software to construct graphs and create information where appropriate. Discuss the relationships that are represented. Well done. And the last one, one of the longest that we've got, plan and conduct statistical investigations by posing investigative questions or identifying a problem and collecting data relevant to the question or problem using surveys and digital tools. Select and use appropriate displays or visualizations. Interpret and communicate findings or solutions within the context. And we're done. A lot of reading from me. I hope it was helpful to you to hear the spoken language, even though I'm gabbling a little bit, probably. I've said this a few times in going through this video. I'm impressed. I used to teach Year 5, so I like this as a year level. But seriously, this content, the way the curriculum has been written for Year 5, is a big, big improvement on what was written in the old one. I think the old one was pretty good. We had a lot to build on, a lot to go on with in the old curriculum, but the new one is improved dramatically. And that is particularly obvious in the Year 5 one. The amount of language that's been added is 40 or 50%, I would estimate, in this particular year level. And the extra language is virtually all useful. It helps teachers understand what's being asked. It helps them come up with learning activities. It clarifies what we're doing here in this, what can be a fairly confusing space in terms of mathematics and what we're teaching and how we teach it and so on. So this has been done very, very well. Having been through all the curriculums, starting with foundation for mathematics, I think I can see the difference in Year 5, that this has been written by someone else, by an expert in mathematics, an expert in mathematics pedagogy, and someone who really knows what they're talking about. And I suspect they've got a lot of experience in teaching in a classroom. And I don't say that lightly, because I regard that very highly as a means of knowing what you're doing in the classroom and having a professionalism and having a professional standard to what you do, because you've been doing it for a long, not just because you've been doing it for a long time, but you think about it and you, I don't mean to sound condescending, that sounded a little condescending, I apologize. But there's a quality to the writing here that is very pleasing to me as a professional, as a fellow professional. And I thoroughly commend you. I could be misreading, this may not be one person, it's probably a team. I'm sure there's a team of people that's been involved, but the primary author of this content has done a spectacularly good job. And I'm very impressed, very, very impressed indeed. Okay, so that's been a novel experience for me, having been very critical of some things that are in the earlier curriculum levels. This is very, very good indeed. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a like and think about subscribing to the channel. That will send you alerts when new content is released in our channel. If you didn't like the video, then please tick the dislike button. And I'm sure I deserve it for whatever it is that you're criticizing me for. And last of all, can I encourage you to leave a comment on this video? This isn't about me. It's not about what I think. It's not about just this individual with idiosyncratic ideas about how math should be taught. I would hope that this becomes part of a conversation between teachers in Australia and we start to unpack what's being asked of us in the new curriculum. And that where necessary, we'll be appropriately professional, but be critical of what's being proposed and what's been included in the new curriculum and what's been left out. So without further ado, that's the end of this video. I've enjoyed talking to you. I hope you have enjoyed hearing it. And I look forward to bringing the last one to you for Year 6. But for now, we're done. Thank you. Goodbye.